Hello, it's Adela with ADASH. I would like to explain what exactly the threshold value is and why we use it in DDS software. The threshold is a parameter which is used in online systems. The threshold idea came from vibration measured on hydroelectric turbines. Such machines are not running continuously. The turbines are run and stopped several times every day, and we want to save just running values. When the machine is turned off, there remains noise values, which we don't want to save. It means, when the values are lower than the threshold value, we do not save them. It will be better to explain it in following examples. You can see the graph of measured values. I decided that my threshold value is 0.5 mm per second. Now I draw the line on this threshold value for demonstration. When the measured value is above, then the machine is running. When the measured value is below, then the machine is not running. To set the threshold correctly is important. How to choose the threshold value? Threshold value has to be lower than normal machine vibrations and higher than noise values. It means, if normal machine vibration is around 2 mm per second and noise value is around 0.2 mm per second, then the threshold value should be set, for example, to 0.5 mm per second. Where you set this value in DDS? Open DDS software. Open your online database. Go through the tree to data cells level. Click on measurement data cell with right mouse button. Choose properties. Go to online tab. You can see saving section here. There is parameter named min value threshold. This parameter stands for the threshold value. Click to the field next to min value threshold name. Fill in your chosen threshold value. You can decide that this data cell threshold value will be set for the whole machine. All data cells on this machine are still measured, but they do not save the data. Machine is considered as not running until this one data cell, marked as threshold data cell, measures values higher than set threshold. From that moment, values are saved in all data cells according to data saving parameters set. Once the threshold is set, it is important to start the measurement again or to press the continue button. From now, values below the threshold will not be saved, unless there is one exception. Imagine that you have measured running value and then the next one is below the threshold. This value is not saved. And also, all other values below threshold after this one are not saved. Next value above the threshold is saved. And it will cause this. Trend of values will look like there is stable high value on the machine, which is not true. Between moment 1 and 2, there were low values because the machine was not running, but you don't know that. This is the reason why ADASH threshold is smarter. When value decreases below the threshold, this first value is saved. Now you know that you are in not running vibration values. Next ones below threshold are not saved, unless the values go up and get above the threshold. The last value before we get again above the threshold is saved also. You can clearly see the difference between the graphs. Keep in mind that threshold parameter should be used only for machines which are not running continuously. It is also important to choose proper value as a threshold value. If you will set it improperly, there can be a lot of values saved. You can see it in this example. If threshold value is set to value 0.2 mm per second, you can see that noise values are oscillating around this point up and down. In such a situation, there is a lot of noise values, which are first below the threshold, it means saved, and a lot of values last below the threshold, it means again saved as the values are oscillating. This could be a good pointer to set the higher value for minimum value threshold. Now you know how to use the threshold parameter. Thank you for watching.